Hi everyone, I'm so excited to say that I'm with Emilia at Sancton Wood School and we're going to be bringing Science of Hazel to the lab, so we'll be showing you lots of practicals. Emilia is going to introduce herself.
Hi, my name is Emilia. I am a lab technician. I work in this school, Sancton Wood School in Cambridge. I am also STEM ambassador, which means I go in other school to introduce science to the kids and we have a lot of fun together. I have also an Instagram page, emilia.science, and follow me to see all my experiments and videos.
Yeah, you should absolutely follow
Thank
her.
You.
Awesome. Hi guys, today we're going to be looking at rates of reaction again, and we're going to be looking at the effect that changing the concentration has on the rate of reaction. We're doing quite a famous experiment, one that involves a cross on a tile, and effectively, when we react our two reactants together, they'll form a precipitate, which over time means that we can no longer see the cross. Don't worry if this sounds complicated, we'll go through it step by step. Just be aware though that we are changing the concentration of the reactant, so that will be our independent variable. Now the two reactants in question are...
Okay, sodium thiosulfate, then I will add water to dilute it.
Yeah.
And then we will add hydrochloric acid, always the same amount, which is 10 ml.
Perfect.
10 cubic centimeter actually.
Yeah, exactly. So notice that our independent variable here is the concentration of sodium thiosulfate. We'll be adding the same volume and same concentration of hydrochloric acid to that. Now what happens when the two reactants mix is you produce water, sodium chloride, sulfur dioxide and sulfur. So be aware that sulfur is the important thing here. It forms a precipitate. And it's that solid which actually obscures the cross and means that we can no longer see it. Notice as well, from a safety point of view, sulfur dioxide is pretty toxic, so we're going to have to be careful that we don't inhale it or get it into our eyes. We're only going to do two concentrations, so starting with the lowest concentration, we've simply got 10 centimeters cubed of sodium thiosulfate mixed with 40 centimeters cubed of water.
Yes.
Amelia swirled the flask to mix the contents.
Yes, and now we're going to add hydrochloric acid. As soon as I add, you start the stopwatch.
Yes.
Yeah?
So she swirled the contents of the flask and now we simply wait. So, according to my timer, it took 3 minutes, 3 seconds in order to obscure the cross. Isn't that amazing? If you consider how clear the cross was to begin with, that sulfur precipitate really has hidden it well. Notice you've got some big issues here with the fact that it's so subjective. I judged it by looking, I used a stop clock, so we're introducing all kinds of reaction time errors, judgment errors, so it isn't the most accurate experiment you'll ever do. Now we're going to try the same experiment, this time with a high concentration of sodium thiosulfate.
Okay, so now we're going to add 40 cubic centimeters of sodium thiosulfate and 10 cubic centimeters of water, right. And then we will add 10 cubic centimeters of hydrochloric acid again.
So we're using a much stronger concentration this time, so we would expect the cross to be obscured far more quickly. I'm ready with my timer.
So again, as soon as we add the acid, we start the time.
Amazing, that reaction occurred super quickly. The cross was obscured at 36 seconds, so much quicker than the lower concentration, just as we would have expected. That's due to there being more reactant particles in the same volume. Far more collisions occurring, and that's why we see that sulfur forming so quickly. Make sure you control the temperature, keep the volumes of the reactants the same in each case, because obviously we want a fair test here. That sulfur dioxide is very smelly.
That is really strong.